What's up, guys? Today in Cooking with EpicConspiracy, I'm going to show all of you how to make the perfect ramen noodles. I know, all of you are saying, come on, Epic, ramen noodles, a baby can make ramen noodles. Probably yes, but can you make a perfect ramen noodle? I have spent many years through testing and trials and tribulations to find out how to make ramen noodles perfect, and I'm going to share it all with you. So let's cook some ramen noodles. All right, the first thing you need is a pan to boil your ramen noodles on. I just use a small little saucepan right here. The first step to perfect ramen noodles is you need to put the correct amount of water into the pan. Now, if you look on the back of the bag of the ramen noodles, it says boil 2 cups of water. No, that's not the perfect way to do it. You want to get a measuring cup and you want to fill it up to 3.5 cups of water, because that's the proper amount of water you need boiling in your pan to get the noodles to the perfect tenderness. So all you do is turn your water on, cold water, and put in 3.5 cups of water right there, and you just pour it right into your saucepan that you're going to boil your noodles in. Now the next step is we have to bring the water to a violent boil. So put your pan of water on your stove and turn the heat to high. You want to bring it to a violent boil. Now while your pot of water is getting to boil, you need to do a couple things to the bag here. Now you can't just open it up and dump it in when the water, you know, is up and boiling. Now this is very important. You need to take the bag and break it in 2 different ways so there's 4 chunks. It's very important because the consistency of the noodles in the boiling, you know, water will tender up the noodles much, much better if you do this. And when you're eating it with your spoon, it's much easier when they're broken up like that to eat the ramen noodles in when they're super long and they're sliding all over your spoon. So make sure you break it this way and this way, 2 different ways. And that's just another step in making the perfect ramen noodle. The next step in cooking the perfect ramen noodle, this is probably one of the most important steps. So if you've been drinking or you're just not in the right frame of mind, but you're starving and you're trying to hurry up and cook, you can make this mistake. When you open the ramen noodle up, be sure to pull out the flavor pack, because it's very easy to be in a hurry to open it up and just dump it in the boiling water with the flavor pack in it. And you don't want to be pulling this out of boiling water. So make sure you pull the flavoring pack out of the ramen noodles. All right, we now have the water at a violent boil. Now you want to empty the ramen noodles, minus the flavoring pack, of course, into the water, just like that. Now, very important, after you empty the noodles into the boiling water, be sure to set your kitchen timer to 5 minutes. 1 minute longer, the noodles will be overcooked. 1 minute or 2 minutes too soon, they will be undercooked. Do not look at the instructions on the back of the package where it says cook in 3 minutes. It takes 5 minutes for the perfect ramen noodle. Now after 3 minutes have elapsed, you want to take your spoon and you want to stir your ramen noodles, kind of break up the blocks of how it's packaged in. Just like this, it's very easy. Now with the water at this temperature and the flames of your oven this high, if you're using a gas stove, it's going to be very hot around here, so you want to be very careful doing this so you don't burn your hand or singe the hair off your arm. And then there's that, and let it cook for the final 2 minutes. Next, you need to decide what you're going to eat your perfect ramen noodles in. Some people, you can use a soup cup, and some people just use a bowl. But right now I'm going to tell you, get rid of the bowl, because it's going to be very hot, and holding it down here, it's going to be hot on your hands. So invest in a nice soup cup with a handle so you can carry it around, you know, to wherever you're going to eat. Now with your ramen noodles finished, 5 minutes has passed, you need to put it into the soup cup. There's many different ways you can do this. I tend just to want to pour it, so just be careful that you don't spill it everywhere. Pour it all in. And when you get down to this much, you just need to be a little bit careful. And there's always going to be a few noodles in the bottom. Just scrape the noodles out. The next step is to put the chicken flavoring pack or whatever flavor that you have into the ramen noodles. Hopefully you took it out of the package, like I said, and you didn't leave it in. Just use scissors,
cut it open. Be very careful not to spill any of this delicious flavoring that you have. And you'll just want to pour it in the soup and then stir. I'll be careful because at first the cup's going to be full of water. It's going to even looks like you're not even going to be able to carry it to wherever you want to go eat it at. But yes, you will, because as you let this cool, the noodles are going to absorb the nutrients of the water in the flavor pack into it. So it's going to be a perfect ramen noodle meal. Now, the next stage of the cooking process is you need to let it sit. I have done tons of testing on this for the perfect amount of time. 15 minutes is how long you're going to want to let this sit. Because at 15 minutes, it's at the perfect temperature where it's not too hot, it's going to burn your mouth, but it hasn't cooled down, so it's going to have the maximum flavor, and the noodles are going to absorb as much of the all the nutrients and deliciousness of the flavoring pack. So 15 minutes, let it sit. And after 15 minutes, the ramen is ready to be eaten. But it's not only just ramen noodles, it's perfect ramen noodles. Ah, so good, so good. So everybody, next time you fix ramen noodles, follow my instructions to get the absolute perfect ramen noodles, the best ramen noodles you can possibly have. Now keep in mind, I have spent many years, and I went through culinary school to develop this routine, you know, this recipe to fix these ramen noodles perfect. So if you mess up, you know, in your first few, you know, 8, 9, 10 attempts, don't get down on yourself, don't get frustrated. It does take lots and lots of practice to master the perfect ramen noodles. So until next time, guys, EpicConspiracy signing out.